Good afternoon, everyone. I'd like to welcome everyone that's come to pay their respects to Tabby Echols, her family. I know a lot of your friends, family, y'all feeling a loss where Tabby passed away. You know, she was my second cousin. I'm the cousin from the country, I guess. My mom, dad lived in Speedwell, which is a pretty rural area on the other side of Withville. And I remember Tabby coming up and spending time with us and how my mom loved to see all of them come up and everything. And you know, as I think back on those years back then, I can't help but think just how lucky we were to grow up in the time and the era that we grew up in then. You know, we played outside all day. They made us come in the house, and we just didn't know how good we had it back then. But again, I thank y'all for coming, and if you would bow your heads for just a moment, we'll start with a word of prayer. Our precious Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we just thank you so much for Tabby's life, Lord, for the memories that we all have of her. And Lord, we pray, dear God, that it would be your will to bring comfort to this loving family, Lord, to each and every one, Lord, that misses her today, Lord. Lord, that you would open our eyes, our hearts, our minds, Lord, that we would see, dear God, that she is in a place, Lord, that there's no more suffering, there's no more pain, there's no more sorrow, no more tears. And Lord, we're glad, Lord, that you are in control. We know, Lord, that we don't always understand, Lord, but we have to realize that you see the big picture, Lord. You know it all before it happens. And Lord, we just come to you and we pray for comfort for each and every one, dear God. Be with us all. Forgive us where we fail you. Forgive us of our shortcomings and our sins. Lord, it's in Jesus Christ's precious name that we pray. Amen. Amen. So, you know, as I got here today and I talked to Tabby's mom a little bit, she told me that Tabby had a couple favorite scriptures, and the one was Psalm 23, "The Lord is my shepherd." Of course, that means a lot to a lot of us, I'm sure. The other one was out of the book of Ecclesiastes, and I pulled my little notes out of my pocket that where the Lord had given me some scriptures for today, and Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1 was the first one I had written down there to open with. So that's how the Lord works. You know, he works in mysterious ways, but he's always right. He's always on time. So in Ecclesiastes 3:1, we read the following words: "To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heavens." And you know, a lot of us are music lovers. We might think that the rock band from California called the Birds back in the 60s might have penned those words. And they did have a song that was a verse to part of it. But those words were originally penned over 200 years before Christ by King Solomon. King Solomon was the wisest man that's ever been on this earth. When God set him up to be king over Israel, he asked Solomon what he wanted, and Solomon didn't pray for riches or wealth or fame or anything like that. He prayed for wisdom. And God honored him with more than just wisdom for that. And Solomon went on to do a lot of things that he had orchards, he had cattle, he had horses, he had things that he invented and worked out, you know, and he was a very smart man, to say the least. But he penned those words, and you know, when I read those, how fitting that was, you know. Tabby's season here on this earth was cut short, but her season in heaven has already begun. You know, the Bible tells us not to weep for those who've gone on, but to weep for those of us who are left here to endure. And like we said in opening, you know, we don't know God's reasoning behind things, but he does. He does. He sees the big picture. We don't. So her time was cut short here on earth. But, you know, she's in some good company, because if you think about it, you got to think about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. His time was cut short here too. His season was ended soon, because at 32 and a half or 33 years of age, he went to the cross of Calvary and he gave his life for us. They didn't take his life from him. He gave it for us. You know, the Bible talks about how Jesus had no home while he was here on this earth. It says that the foxes had holes and the birds had nests, but the Son of Man had no place to lay his head. He spent a lot of time with his friends, Lazarus, Mary, Martha, Simon, Peter, and all of them. Jesus had no home of his own. When he was born here, he was born into a manger because there was no room at the inn. So he was cut short, but that was Jesus's purpose. It talks about a time to every purpose under heaven. His purpose was to go to the cross and die for us. And he fulfilled his purpose. And you know, God has use of Tabby. So she fulfilled her purpose and God has took her home. She did not suffer all the cancer that she had and everything. She was taken mercifully. She didn't suffer. So she's with good company in Jesus doing that. We have two or three songs that we want to play, and we're gonna play the first one right now, if that'll be okay.
When I get where I'm going, on the far side of the sky, the first thing that I'm gonna do is spread my wings and fly. I'm gonna land beside a lion and run my fingers through his mane, or I might find out what it's like to ride a drop of rain. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. Gonna walk with my granddaddy, and he'll match me step for step. And I'll tell him how I've missed him every minute since he left. And then I'll hug his neck. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will share the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. So much pain and so much darkness, this world we stumble through, all these questions I can't answer, so much work to do. But when I get where I'm going, and I see my Maker's face, I'll stand forever in the light of His amazing grace.
You know, as we thought back this week over Tabby's life and the things that we remembered about her and what she meant to us, we found some old pictures. I guess I was about 8 or 9 years older than she was, and I found some where when she visited my mom, I was pushing her in a Tonka truck through the yard and her just in a diaper and that little red hair that she had there. She didn't have a whole lot, but it was red and it was very pretty. So, you know, we all have our own memories of Tabby. One thing that we know, she loved stray animals. She took in all kind of animals, and that must run in the family, because I know some others that are like that too. One thing that I found amusing about her was how they told me that she had a green thumb, you know, and she could grow about anything. I heard about the Christmas cactus that she put two of them together and it grew into a beautiful plant. You know, that reminded me so much of Tabby's grandmother, Ruth, and my Aunt Maxine and my mom. You know, they could break a dead twig off something and put it in a glass of water overnight and then stick it down in a pot of dirt and it'd usually grow for them. That's how they were. But we all have our special memories about her. We'll look at a little bit more scripture here today to try to draw comfort from in a situation such as this. But you know, that's a good thing about the Bible. No matter what you're facing or no matter what you're going through, you can find something in there that will comfort you and will relate to the situation that you're in. We talked a little bit about Solomon. Solomon had a very famous father. His father was King David. The Bible describes King David as a man after God's own heart. And one thing, if you read and study at all about King David, you'll find out that he was very human. David messed up a whole lot. But David knowed how to go back to God and repent for what he'd done and ask the Lord to forgive him. So David had messed up and had caused Bathsheba, who was married to another man, to have a child. And God wasn't happy with David. God sent Nathan the prophet to talk to David, as he did back in those days before Christ. And in the second book of Samuel, the 12th chapter, we pick up at verse 15, it says, "And Nathan the prophet departed into his house, and the Lord struck the child that Uriah's wife bare unto David, and it was very sick." Now, this was just a child. But like we said about people's seasons being cut short and stuff, this was another. This was an infant. It goes on and said that David therefore besought God for the child. He prayed to God, "God, spare my child." And David fasted, and he went in, and he lay all night upon the earth. You know, David stopped eating, and he was mourning. He went in and laid down on the ground. It goes on and says, "And that the elders of his house arose and went to him to raise him up from the earth, but he would not, neither did he eat bread with them. And it came to pass on the seventh day that the child died. And the servants of David feared to tell him that the child was dead, for they said, 'Behold, while the child was yet alive, we spake unto him, and he would not hearken unto our voice. How will he then vex or hurt himself if we tell him that the child is dead?' But when David saw that his servants whispered, David perceived that the child was dead. Therefore David said unto his servants, 'Is the child dead?' And they said, 'He is dead.' Then David arose from the earth and washed and anointed himself and changed his apparel and came into the house of the Lord and worshiped. Then he came to his own house, and when he required, they set bread before him, and he did eat. Then said his servants unto him, 'What thing is this that thou hast done? Thou didst fast and weep for the child while it was alive. But when the child was dead, thou didst rise and eat bread.' And he said, David said, 'While the child was yet alive, I fasted and wept, for I said, Who can tell whether God will be gracious to me, that the child may live? But now he is dead. Wherefore should I fast? Can I bring him back again? I shall go to him, but he shall not return to me. And you know, when we think of death and how much of a loss it is to lose someone, these words out of the Bible provide as much comfort as anything in the Bible that I know of. Simply because here David is telling us where they're at, they wouldn't return if they could. They're happy. They're with the Lord. They're in heaven. So it's up to us to go to them. To see Tabby again, we have to make it to where she is, to go to heaven. That's what we should focus on from this point forward, to make sure we're ready to go to be with her there, with all our loved ones that's gone on. We got a lot of them. We got a lot of them. And we all miss them terribly. So, you know, we should strive to make sure that we're ready to go and be with them, because they won't come back to us. They wouldn't if they could. And we'll go on to the second song at this time, please.
Looking back on the memory of the dance we shared beneath the stars above, for a moment all the world was right. How could I have known that you'd ever say goodbye? And now, glad I didn't know the way it all would end, the way it all would go. Our lives are better left to chance. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the day. Holding you, I held everything, and for a moment wasn't I the king? But if I'd only known how the king would fall, yeah, who's to say? You know I might have changed it all. And now, glad I didn't know the way it all would end, the way it all would go. Our lives are better left to chance. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the day. Yes, my life is better left to chance. I could have missed the pain, but I'd have had to miss the day. Thank you.
I have just a couple more and I'll close here shortly, but we all deal with death differently. We all have our own ways of grieving and everything. It's never easy, and unfortunately it never goes away. But we are able to get through it with the Lord's help, and like I've tried to say, we can find comfort in the Scripture and in God's Word. We can find comfort when I lost my own mother several years ago. There was one verse of Scripture in the 5th chapter of 2 Corinthians that Paul wrote that I drawed great comfort from and still do today. I'll read it now. In it, Paul says, "We are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord." You know, that tells us a whole lot. That tells us that when we take our last breath here on this earth, that we go straight to be with the Lord in heaven. If we're saved, that's where we go. We go to be present with the Lord. And I'm confident that that's where Tabby is today, and that we can see her again, like we brought out about King David. We can go to where she is. There's no waiting period. There's no sleep. We go immediately to be with the Lord. That's my understanding of the Bible, and I don't claim to be a preacher, but I do not try to explain the word of the Lord as he's revealed it to me. I'm not into much religion. In fact, I tried to do like a feller in an old song I heard years ago said he'd traded his religion for salvation. You know, religion and formal religion, I'll take a relationship with Jesus Christ any day over religion. And I pray that all of you know the Lord as your Savior, you have a personal relationship with Him. You can draw great strength in times of trouble and times like this from Him. So we have one more song we're going to play right now, and then I'll close.
Sing my share of broken hands.
Sing my share.
You know, it is true that the Bible does speak much more of hell than it does of heaven, but thank God for the passages in the Bible where heaven is described a little bit. One such being in 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, where again Paul writes to us, and he says, "But as it is written, eye hath not seen, nor ear heard, neither hath entered into the heart of man, the things which God hath prepared for them that love him." And you know, if you listen to those words and they sink in a little bit and that don't make you want to join Tabby in heaven, I don't know, friends and family, what will. It hasn't even entered into our mind, into our imagination, how great, wonderful heaven is going to be for us. We can't even imagine it, you know. Heaven is just described in the Bible as the city four square with walls of jasper and gates of pearl and streets of pure gold, so pure that they're translucent, you can see through them. So it's my prayer today that instead of questioning God in a situation like this, we realize that he knows, he's all-seeing, all-knowing God. He sees the big picture. Tabby is at home with him. No more suffering, no more pain, no more tears. And that we strive to go to be with her. That's our hope. That's our only hope. And that is done through a relationship with Jesus Christ. I hope you know him today. I hope you know him. You know, like I was talking about, when we grew up, we didn't face a lot of the things that's going on in the world today. They were unknown. They were unheard of. The Bible tells us that time will wax worse and worse. So, you know, things are going to get worse before they get any better. So you can draw great strength and comfort in knowing Jesus Christ. And I would like to close now with a word of prayer. And then we'll conclude the service. Will you bow your heads with me, please? Our precious Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you again in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, we just thank you. We thank you for Tabby's life. We thank you for the memories, Lord, that we all have of her, our own special ones, Lord. No one can take those away. Lord, we thank you for letting her share her time and her talents, her love of animals, her green thumb, everything about her, Lord. We thank you so much for each and everything, Lord. Lord, we pray right now that you will lead, guide, and direct us all, Lord, that you will comfort this family, dear God, as only you can, Lord. Draw us all closer together, Lord. Show us that our petty differences are not worth hard feelings or grudges or being mad at one another or anything like that, Lord, that what little bit of family we have left, Lord, we need to draw closer to one another, dear God. And Lord, we just thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for his death on that cross. We thank you that you raised him from the dead, Lord. We're thankful that we know where he is right now, Lord, for you tell us in your word that he's seated right next to you, dear God, to make intercession for us, his children. We thank you for that, Lord. We thank you, Lord, if there's one here that don't know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, Lord, that he's standing at their heart's door, Lord, knocking on it, Lord. Lord, we pray that they would open the door and let him in, Lord. He says he'll come in his word. Lord, we thank you for your scriptures, your word. Lord, we pray that for safe travels as each and every one departs this place today, Lord, that you'd get us all back home safely, Lord. We thank you for everything you've done for us, all your blessings upon us. Lord, forgive us where we fail you. Forgive us our sins, Lord, for it's in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
This ends the celebration of life service for Tabatha Sue Echols. Thank you, Joey, and thank you for being here to celebrate with the family. Please come forward and comfort the family at this time.